Today, here we're in this $147 million State of the Arts Center for Teaching and Research that will define MTSU's second century of service to the people of this great state. The science building is critical to our continuing efforts to provide Tennessee with a workforce equipped for the challenges of the 21st century, particularly in science, technology, engineering, and math. About 80% of our 24,000 students will be taking a class in this building. Our new science building provides a space for inspiration. This space will inspire learning, thinking. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we make history with the formal opening of this long-awaited facility. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming my friend, friend of this state, the governor of the great state of Tennessee, Governor Bill Haslam.
Thank you. This is a really big day. Do you know how you know it's a big day? The skyboxes are full. This is a significant day, and as you gathered from listening to Dr. McPhee, it's one that a lot of people have been working on for a long time before we ever showed up on the scene. And right when I started showing up on the scene, Dr. McPhee started working on me in a very aggressive manner. When I was still a governor wannabe, I was running for governor, and I was invited to come to a basketball game at MTSU, and I thought that was great. And so Dr. and Mrs. McPhee had Christy and I come to the game, and we're sitting there. Silly me, I thought I was there to see a basketball game. I learned I was there to hear all about a science building and how critical it was to the future of the state. But I say that with a great deal of respect. That's how leadership happens, is people commit themselves to a goal and they work at it relentlessly. And Dr. McPhee and the MTSU family didn't just work on me. They also made certain that your legislative delegation was actively engaged. And so from Representative White and Representative Carr and Representative Sparks and Senator Tracy and Senator Ketron, I never ever sat down with them when MTSU and the science building didn't come up. This is a really great time to be true blue, but it's also a really, really critical time to be true blue. Everybody knows about the growth that's happening in Middle Tennessee, kind of in the heart of this school's market, if you will, and all of the Nashville and the surrounding counties, and the growth that's happening there is kind of almost unprecedented in our state history. But what it means is there is a lot more a population that needs a quality education beyond high school. As you will know, one of our biggest goals is what we call a drive to 55, a move to have 55% of our population have a degree beyond high school. But if we're going to get there, MTSU is a critical piece of that. It just makes sense because of MTSU's role in this state. And if we're going to attract those jobs we want, we have to be a state that is deep in science talent. And the people that are impacted through this building have a bigger role than just, I'm taking a science class at MTSU, but you're part of where we're driving the state. If Tennessee is going to be the state that is ready for the future that awaits us, MTSU plays a critical role. And this building and the preparation of students for the STEM disciplines is right at the heart of that. I didn't know the number you said, about 80% of the students on campus will take a class in this building. That makes it even more critical as you look at the future of the state. So congratulations, it is a great day to be true blue. Thanks.
Many of you in education have heard the term STEM, science, education, technology, engineering, and mathematics. MTSU is on the verge of putting an A in and changing the name to STEAM, the A representing agriculture. Many of you know I've had the pleasure to travel with Dr. McPhee to China for the last 2 years, and the collaborative agreement that we have signed with the Guangji Botanical and Medicinal Gardens, who have now given us access because of that agreement to medicinal plants that have never been seen in the Western Hemisphere. We have them upstairs because of that relationship now. And we're on the verge of coming out with drugs from those plants for autoimmune disease, for cancer. We had our commissioner, Julius Johnson here just last week, showing him what we're doing with ginseng and the possibilities of our agriculture community can start growing this. They can compress the growing time in our labs down to about 2 months compared to 8 or 9 years in the wild. Thank you so much.
The building is iconic in style and function. Its beauty lies not only in aesthetics, but in its potential to impact the lives of many, many students working with extraordinary faculty that all will enjoy this facility and those benefits for years to come. Today, Governor, each of our Board of Regents institutions, with MTSU at the forefront, is genuinely focused on meeting the state's goal to increase the number of college graduates. This science building will help position the board and its leadership leadership role to fulfill the drive to 55. Students who come to this building will have access to state-of-the-art facilities, and I would suggest to you access to world-class programs taught by world-class faculty. So on behalf of the Tennessee Board of Regents, again, I congratulate MTSU and everyone involved to make this historic day possible. Thank you very much.
Last night, we recognized and honored those whose generous contribution were crucial to the completion of this facility. First, Dr. Liz Ray, one of our top cheerleaders and one of the great MTSU supporters. We want to thank Dr. Ray, and I'm pleased to announce that the area where we stand today will forever be known as the Liz and Creighton Ray Atrium. Dr. Ray, thank you so much. Please stand and let us recognize you for the incredible support of this university for many, many, many years. Thank you.
The first day of classes, which started back in August, Dr. Fisher, who had in fact camped out in this building for a month, he was standing right here in the atrium, and he asked me to describe this building in one word. And I thought for a few seconds, and I decided that the word was inspiring. The building is inspiring for faculty and for students. For many faculty, the building offers, finally, the necessary equipment and space to pursue cutting-edge research, full steam ahead. And the teaching and learning classrooms and laboratories are clean, well-equipped, bright, functional, and safe. There's many learning spaces situated throughout the building, little alcoves and corners, open areas, including the beautiful second-floor mezzanine. Students are free to sit and work on homework, to study alone or in groups, to socialize and eat. I watched the student behavior at the beginning of the semester with some curiosity and amusement. They were not sure what to make of it all. Is it okay if I work here? Is this for us? It only took 2 weeks' time, and students colonized these areas. Now our students are fully equipped to compete with other students, any other student, anywhere in the country, for jobs in the sciences, for placement in professional schools, and acceptance into graduate programs. And students with majors outside of chemistry and biology will take classes in this building to prepare them as informed citizens, ready to take on an economy and a society where scientific literacy will only grow in importance. This beautiful building is a magnet for recruiting students and new faculty. The 21st century future is here, now. 2 weeks ago, the sciences played host to more than 100 fourth graders. And afterwards, one of the little girls said, "This is where I'm going to go to college. I'm going to MTSU." And then she looked at me real serious and she said, "Will you still be here?" This is a very happy day for MTSU students and faculty, and we are genuinely, deeply grateful to everyone who's made this possible. Thank you.
As a freshman, when I first walked into the Weiser Patton building in 2011, it took me a while to get used to my surroundings. I remember walking into a crowded Chemistry 1 lab with little to no natural light, no places to study, and shoulder to shoulder next to my lab partner. So when I heard that a new building was being made for 2014, directly made for sciences, I was thinking, what are the changes? What are they gonna do? So when I got here and I stepped through the doors for the first time, I was blown away. Within the building, there are broad open lobbies and study rooms, student-based classrooms, and technology everywhere. Each classroom is like walking into the future. Everything is advanced, works perfectly, and most importantly, is directed at us, students. So I want to thank MTSU and everybody who had a hand in this, because I don't believe that you could have made this any better. Thank you.
Thank you, Kenneth. Doesn't it make you feel great for students like this and others in the building here today? The future is only great. We want to thank all of our speakers today for being a part of the program. We'd also like now to ask all members of the platform party to make their way over to the big blue ribbon in front of the main doors.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.